Hi, Rich Spisano from Digitally Fearless here again, and today I'm going to teach you how to create unique lettering. Sometimes you don't want to use standard fonts for your logo or sometimes the header of your website, so I'm going to show you how you can change that up so people can't just copy it and put it on another site and type whatever they want. So here we have a page with a black background. In fact, I will lock that background so it cannot move. So now I'm going to add some lettering. So let's choose the type tool. Let's give it the color white. Doesn't even matter. In fact, I'll show you. I'll give it any color. So let's give it the color blue. And I will type my way in Arial black. And let's put that somewhere around here. Now I'm going to pull out my guidelines from the rulers. If you don't see the rulers, check out my top 20 tips video. So I'm going to pull out a guide approximately there. Doesn't have to be perfect. It's up to you. It's up to your taste. And here, that looks pretty good. Now I'm selecting my text, and I'm going to say layer and convert to curves. And now you have a group right here. This is the after one, so I'm just going to hide that for now. So here's your group. What I like to do is ungroup it so I could work with each letter separately without affecting the group. So I right-click on the whole group, and I click on ungroup. And now each letter is separate to work with without worrying about the group getting in the way. So let's try with the letter M. I'll go here, and this is my node tool. If you don't see it, go to the pen tool and go down here. And now we have nodes. If you double click on a line in between the nodes, actually I'm wrong. If you single click on a line between the nodes, you add another node. So I'm holding shift because right now I'm bringing it down straight and my snapping is on, so it's going to snap to this guideline. I'm going to do that again, right here, and right here, and I think I'll even bring this one straight up to the top. Now let's work on the Y. The Y, I think I'll just pick a second one, just the bottom, and I'll only do one. It's to your taste. The W, I'll place one here, and maybe another one right here. You can also curve anything, because if you click on these, you can do curve lines, but I am not curving anything right now. I want to do straight fonts. And then here, I will maybe just bring that one down, and that one down. And here, maybe just that up here. That looks pretty good to me. So now I'm going to go into effects, which I'll pick any letter. Right now the top one here says Y. I'll go right below where it says effects. And let's do a gradient overlay. And I did from black to white. You could do any color you want. I will do also a 3D effect, which if you look at the 3D effect, I'm just bringing the radius up to wherever I feel comfortable with, and I think that looks pretty good right there. And I think I'm doing an outer glow effect too, and what I'll do just for this particular one is I'll pick a lime green just to give it a glowing effect, and I'll bring the radius up. Maybe the intensity down, but bring the radius up, almost like a nice sci-fi glow. And I'm going to close that. So now I have this layer selected, and I'm going to do edit, copy, and I'll select all the rest of the layers. I'm holding shift while I put the top one here and the next layer. So these are all selected in between, and then I'll do edit, paste effects. And there you have it. So this is a nice way to create your own idea for a logo. In fact, I think I'll even add on the Y think I would like a point here. Just, you know, bring that one down too. There, that looks much better. So that was a quick tip on how to create unique lettering. If you felt this video was useful, please click like and subscribe. Thank you very much.